in the Renoise Pattern Editor and the Phrase Editor of both Renoise and Redux, many values use the hexadecimal system. If you're unfamiliar with this concept, it can be confusing to see letters amongst the numbers. So this video will give you an understanding of exactly what's going on. We're all familiar with counting. A digit has a range of 0 to 9. It counts upward one at a time. And after reaching 9, it becomes 10, 1, 0. The counting begins again, going up to 19. Then it becomes 20, 2, 0. And so on until 99. In hexadecimal though, the digit range doesn't stop at 9. It extends past this, with the letters A, B, C, D, E, and F, which represent the values we know in decimal as 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. It then becomes 1, 0, which represents 16. The counting begins again, going up to 1F, and then becomes 20, which is 32, and so on until FF. So, in decimal, the range of possible values with two digits is 100, 00 to 99. In hexadecimal, the range of 00 to FF is 256. This allows for more instruments and samples to be represented by just two digits, and also gives greater accuracy for the volume, panning, and delay columns. And also, when applying values to effect commands. It's important to note though that although the values in the effect column use hex, the effect commands themselves do not. They use letters, but it's to represent what the effect does. For example, S for slice, V for vibrato, R for retrigger, etc. So where did hex come from and why are we using it? Well, it has its roots in binary and coding, but the real reason it's used in Renoise and Redux is because of their tracker heritage, where efficiency and that extra resolution was very important. And even though much has changed, these things are still relevant in our interface for patterns and phrases. It can take a while to get used to working this way, but it does become easy. And to get started, here's a simple example of the most useful hexadecimal values. 00 is 0%. 40 is equal to 25%. 80, 50%. C0 is 75%. And FF is the maximum value at 100%.